Yeah.
Oh, our God. Oh, we are despised. Oh, turn their insults back on their own heads. Give them over to plunder in the land of captivity. Oh, he didn't heckle back. Oh, he called on the name of the Lord. He didn't talk back. He didn't debate. He didn't fight against them. All he did was call a spontaneous prayer meeting and began to call on the Lord. Say to your neighbor, neighbor, oh neighbor, if you want to press, you better learn how to pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Jesus' name. Somebody here, you don't have the victory because, you've given up. You stopped pressing. You became discouraged. You began to hear what they had to say and turn away. But God is saying today that if you want to continue to press through your trials, press through your tribulation, press through your ministry, press through such a time as this, you better know that God is the power behind the press.
Right.
Say to your neighbor, neighbor, oh neighbor, God is the power. Behind the press.
Behind the press.
In Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord.
God is the power behind the press.
Mm-hmm.
He called on the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And he called and began to pray an imprecatory prayer in verse 5, calling down God's judgment.
He said,
do not cover up their guilt or blot out their sins from your sight, for they have thrown insults in the face of the builders.
Yeah. My Lord.
He called on the Lord. And he didn't say, Lord, bless him.
Oh, no, he didn't.
He didn't even say what Jesus said from the cross. Lord, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
That's right.
Oh, he thought that this work was so important that any opposition that he would face would have to deal with the Lord.
Yeah.
Oh, don't you know, oh Christian man and Christian woman, any opposition that you face, they should have to deal with the Lord. They should have to deal with the Lord. I talked about this illustration when I first came to the church about how the devil was knocking on the door, knocking on the door, knocking on the door. Oh, and how the man went and answered the door, and he saw that it was the devil.
Yeah.
And he turned to Jesus and said, Jesus, it's for you. It's for you. Somebody here.
Yeah.
Oh, you're trying to fight your own battles. Oh. You're trying to press in your own strength.
Yeah.
But you better learn to do what Nehemiah did. Nehemiah, as they were opposing his work, his ministry, he said, God, it's for you.
Yeah.
And you take care of it.
Right.
Jesus.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Don't you know any trials, any tribulations that you have faced this last week, this last month? Don't you know that trial is not for you, but it's for the Lord?
Right.
Hello, somebody.
That's right. Say that.
And once he got his power and strength from the Lord, then he was able to press through, or they were able to press through some handiwork or some hard work.
Right.
Come on.
Yeah, Lord.
Some
All right.
of you here today, you better get that power from the Lord to pass through some handiwork. You've been discouraged. You've been disappointed. You've been depressed. Oh, and you thought, just because you were pressing and it didn't seem like you were getting anywhere or nowhere. Oh, you've been talking about building for years. Well, you better do something.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And if you want God to build a building, guess what you got to do? You got to press on with this hard work, this work. If you believe, you better press on giving.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody.
Don't
get discouraged. You better press on.
Press on.
In Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And they pressed on through the hard work.
Mm-hmm.
It says, and we build the wall.
Mm-hmm.
oh, until all of it reached half its height.
Right.
For the people worked.
They worked.
With all their heart.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Lord.
You want to know whether you're pressing for the Lord?
Mm-hmm.
Are you doing it with all your heart?
All right. Well.
If you're not doing it with all your heart, guess what? You're not pressing for the Lord. You've already given up. If what you do is you're giving God your second best, oh, you're not pressing.
Come on. Yeah.
Oh, for in order for this man to get stronger, he had to press against the rock with all of his might. And somebody here, your hands have gotten weak. Oh, your press has gotten weak. And God has sent me here today to tell you that God is saying to you, oh, you better press on, press on. In Jesus' name. Yeah. Even if nobody shows up, you better press on. Even if nobody comes to pray me, you better press on. Even if nobody give to the building community, you better press on. Even if your mate won't change, you better press on. Ain't gonna give you nothing.
Come on,
all his job is to do is to give you a hard time.
Right.
And he's on his job.
Yeah.
Oh, what would Michael Jordan look like? Oh, when they were triple teaming him, saying, "Oh, I'm gonna give up. They won't let me shoot the ball." Hello, somebody.
Yep.
One of the ways that you know that you're on the right track. So keep pressing.
Yes. Yeah, keep pressing.
Nice.
Keep pressing.
Keep pressing.
Yeah.
And if it seems like that the devil is double team and triple teaming you now, guess what? You better continue to press on.
Yeah.
Come on.
In Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, somebody.
Yes.
But they press on regardless of the heckling, pressed into the heavens and began to do some handiwork or some hard work.
Hard work.
Hard work. Manual labor.
Come on.
Mm-hmm. They began to build so much so that it came up half of its height.
Mm-hmm.
It's amazing what we can accomplish when the people have a mind to do what God
wants. Yes, that's it. Amen.
Oh, let me say that again. Yeah, go ahead and give God a hand clap of praise.
Yeah. Amen.
To do God's work.
Yeah.
You've got to have a mind like Jesus had. Jesus said in John chapter 9 that I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day, the night coming when no man can work.
Yeah.
Jesus had that desire to work for the Lord. Yeah. And he said that this is something that I must do.
Yeah, must do.
Yes.
I was thinking, I'm 43 years old, and if the Lord let me get to the average age of an African American man, is I think they say is 79, don't you know I'm halfway past my point?
Right.
My time is running out.
Yes, sir.
Right. Right. Right.
And there are some of you who are past 40.
But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.